Hi everyone, how are you doing? We're in the Open World Cup in Russia, which is starting next month, June 14th. My guest today is Russian. Hello, nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
So let's speak Russian. Where's the vodka?
No, in Russia, vodka is popular, but I don't like
it. I don't like vodka. So, what are you drinking?
Now?
Yeah.
It's caipirinha.
Caipirinha.
Like Brazilian cocktail.
Yeah, you know that this is our intangible heritage. How does it taste?
Oh, very nice. Yeah, I like it.
No, so let's toast. I think it's
Nazdarovia.
Nazdarovia.
But really, Russians not say it's translated, but not Russian. When they are drinking, we don't say.
I know.
No.
What do they say?
It depends on the situation. For example, if we only meet the first time, they say for meeting. Maybe if it's the second or for good reasons, for good.
No, at this moment, what is Russian word we say?
Знакомство.
Знакомство.
Знакомство. For meeting.
Yeah. You don't know that I just know.
Or встреча. It's not first meeting.
Ah, okay. So it's first straight.
Yes.
Yeah. So didn't know that I know some Russian words. I didn't tell. Let me try. Привет.
Привет.
Hello. Yeah, so Vult Marshall.
Yes, my name is Marshall.
Yes. Mandy Sorroclit.
Yes, I have 40 years.
Yeah, 40. Diego Maruska.
Yeah, I don't speak Russian.
So it's great. You know that my dream to go to Russia because I'm very not sure to take it. Police officer to move red heat in front of red heat, and because of a circle, Moscow state circles, right? You know that in Portuguese, if you listen to people speaking here, you realize that some words we pronounce sound their words in Russian, like for example, Nahui. Very well.
Yeah.
Don't translate.
I don't use that.
Okay, so after this warm up, I'd like to start asking you to tell us about your life in your country.
I'm a teacher of mathematics, also I'm a programmer, but I like travel. I like to spend many time in other countries. But when I arrive in my country, I work like a teacher, but I work not. I have no official job. I'm working through internet, by Skype. I have a students, and I give them lessons of mathematics and programming.
And Russian.
In Russian, yes.
So how about your country? Did your parents live socialist?
Yes. My parents was born in socialist time, 15th year. They lived 35 years during the socialism.
So, what did he say about it?
My mother hate the time because all was prohibited. It was prohibited to read some books, to listen some music, to visit different countries. It was prohibited to make your business. You need only to go to job and all was for government.
Okay.
But my father. Earlier they also hated, now but now he said there was a good reason, socialism time, because all was free, without money, education, medicine, people had possibilities to became study, to became some profession, like doctor, like scientist, like engineer.
How about the World Cup? How do you like soccer, football?
I'm not interested by football, but World Cup, one side, it's good opportunity for our county to develop infrastructure like railways, like roads, like hotels, like stadiums. But other, there are big problems because our government is a little bit crazy by security. They close all the zones, they put fences everywhere for check movements of all the people. And for example, if you want to come to metro station or railway station, you need to pass like in the airport. You need to scan your security, scan your bags, your clothes, it spent many time. I hate it because it was unusually. On the other side, there is no sense because terrorism. Which are afraid of our government, and terrorists can make terrorists without it.
Do you think Russia is prepared in case of terrorism?
Yes, generally it's prepared, but government has more much that really needed.
Why this guy? What they are fighting for? Exploding for? What is the political issue involving the terrorists?
Our government afraid terrorism because we have a war with Islamic State. Now we had in Syria. Also we have we had a war in Chechnya region. South part of Russia, it's Islamic Republic, and there are many terrorists who want to Chechnya will be independent, and it's Islamic protectorate. But now it's like all is calm in Chechnya, but there are many people who don't like it, who want to separate Chechnya from Russia. And there is many terrorists inside the forest in this republic or neighbor republics. And there are many terrorists outside Russia in Islamic State. But I think that terrorism is not a big problem because this problem is government should defend us to terrorism. But what he's doing? They put fences everywhere. They put scanners for bags for all this. They ask to every people who want to come to some metro station or railway station to check their bags or clothes. It's crazy because they spend very much time.
How do Russians react to this? How do Russians see the World Cup, the second biggest event of the world?
Russians content because Russians generally like football. Sorry,
you don't like it.
I'm not interesting. I don't understand why it's playing. It's not influence of my life.
Guys running around.
And I also cannot
run up the ball.
Yes, I also cannot influence by this game. I don't know how I need to interest by this by football or by other some other game. I'm interested by things who can be useful for me or who can be useful for other people.
Yes, and I see that you have traveled a lot, over around 40 countries. What did you learn from this experience?
Sorry?
You have traveled a lot all over the world.
70 countries.
70 countries, wow. So, what did you learn from this experience?
It's a good experience. I traveled 15 years. Because you can see by your eyes what you have about you have heard earlier. Also, this experience allows you have no set of tips about something down. It's like, for example, in Africa, all people are white, or for example, in South America, where everywhere is dangerous, or in the United States, or in very cold people. It's interesting to communicate with people from other countries, from other cultures, and understand good your planet, our Earth, that we are like all the brothers, and when you travel, you understand it.
Yeah, yes. And how did you learn English?
It was a very big experience, because I started to learn English in the school. After I learned in other school, after university, after in postgraduate school, high school, and after. But really, I can I studied really my English in my travel, because when you travel, you use it all the day English.
Universal language.
Yes, and without using, you cannot speak.
You speak.
Before my traveling, I spoken very, very bad.
You speak French and Spanish too.
Yes,
How did you get it?
I studied French in my first school, 7 years, but I hated it. It was very difficult. It's very difficult language, but now I am grateful for the school, because I can speak French. Somebody from French speaking countries, and I also speak Spanish, because I traveled in South America 1 year, and I studied here during my travel. I had one small book for Spanish for 90 days. I read it. I made exercises from this book, and after I tried to practice, and now can.
First step, just sit down and start. And you know, guys,
we're on the beach. Hello.
George is my guest from Couchsurfing. You know, Couchsurfing is a website that you find places all over the world to stay for free. And it's a way to exchange culture, meet new people, know their life, interact. And you can find hosts, and they offer their home for free, as I'm hosting George, my friend. So, George, what is the importance of Couchsurfing?
At first, that it's possibility to meet new people. I really like this Couchsurfing. I use it more than 100 times. At first, it's when you come to some place, you can more good with local people. And also, you will have many friends from around all the world. I have friends in Africa, in South America, in Iran, in China, in Hong Kong, in Russia, in Europe, everywhere.
Wow.
Also, I accept guests in my house in Russia sometimes. Also, it's very good experience, and you can show you your city to foreigners. So many interesting place and
the best place and
yes,
the safest.
By example,
as well.
if I come to a hotel or hostel, I don't know about the city nothing. I will move in the city, but I will not see some interesting.
And you know where walking around if it's safe or not. Another question about Couchsurfing is about references. How do they work?
Okay, by example, you host me, and doctor, when you host me, I leave you a reference about you, that you are a good guy, you host me well.
Good experience or not?
Yes. All things was very good, and you also leave me a message that I could guess that was very well. It's very good good practice because when somebody, when for example, I want to use Couchsurfing next time, I write somebody and he reads, or his wife has many good references. I host him, I can it will be no problem for you also. If you also want to travel, you can use Couchsurfing, and somebody reads that you accept many guests and you as a good guy, and after sometimes happens bad clothes, bad drinks, and it's also good to describe what happens for warning to other members. It's, this member is not so good, be careful. But usually there is no problem. If you want to start to travel and you have no references, it's good to host people to receive references from them, and also you can start to try. Because, for example, when I accept the request, I can see it everywhere. I look everywhere. I look always that have you these people as member reference or not. If has many good references, okay, no problem.
So, just to finish, can you do me a favor?
What?
Can you do me a favor? Speak a bit Russian. Tell us a brief of what we've talked here in our conversation in Russian, please.
Ну, всем привет. Желаю всем удачи. Регистрируйтесь в Couchsurfing, это очень хороший сайт. Путешествуйте, познавайте мир. Счастливо.
So, спасибо.
Не за что.
Thank you very much, my friend.
Bye-bye, guys.